1599, the original Globe Theatre was built from upcycled, recycled wood.
This was actually the timber frame of another playhouse, simply called the Theatre, situated on the north side of the River Thames. It was dismantled piece by piece, and beam by beam was carried across the frozen Thames in the winter of 1598, and rebuilt about 100 yards from where I sit now. This happened because of sheer tenacity, will, and necessity.
In 1599, wood was the main source of heat and energy. To keep up with the ever-increasing demand from people and industry, deforestation of English woodland was happening at an alarming rate, and wood was in short supply. An alternative fuel source was needed, and fast.
So people turned to coal, more specifically sea coal, a cheaper alternative to the increasingly expensive timber.
But the short-term benefit of burning both wood and sea coal did not take into account the long-term impact on people and the planet. Population growth, urbanization, globalized trade, mass consumption, nature as a commodity to be bought and sold, colonized and conquered.
All of this destabilized the delicate balance and interconnected relationship between human beings and the natural world.
Convenience, social progress, employment and profit were all won at the expense of public health, environmental devastation and planetary risk. Mankind, the wealthy kind of man, placed himself firmly at the center of the universe, seeking dominion over all the earth. The impact of human-made climate change had begun. The Anthropocene had begun. The Capitalocene had begun. At the same time as discovering brave new worlds.
We were also destroying them.
The sea hath bounds, but deep desire hath none.
The earth is thronged by man's oppression, and the poor worm doth die for it.
And that it was great pity, so it was. This villainous saltpeter should be digged out of the bowels of the harmless earth. Our vineyards, fallows, meads, and hedges, defective in their natures, grow to wildness.
Oh, ruined piece of nature, this great world shall so wear out to naught.
Are you not moved when all the sway of earth shakes like a thing unfirm?
Never till tonight, never till now, did I go through a tempest dropping fire?
The winds piping to us in vain, as in revenge have sucked up from the sea contagious fogs, which falling in the land hath every pelting river made so proud that they have overborne their continents.
Rheumatic diseases do abound.
I know not where to hide my head.
We cannot live on grass, on berries, water, as beasts and birds and fishes.
And this same progeny of evils comes from our debate, from our dissension.
We are their parents and original.
Hear nature, hear, dear goddess, hear.
One touch of nature makes the whole world kin.
I know a bank where the wild tide blows, where the ox lips and the nodding violet grows.
Quite over canopied with luscious woodbine, with sweet musk roses, and with eglantine.
And this our life, exempt from public haunt, finds tongues in trees, books in the running brooks, sermons in stones, and good in everything.
Canst tell how an oyster makes his shell?
No.
Nor I, neither.
The great globe itself, yea, all which it inherit, shall dissolve. We are such stuff as dreams are made on. And our little life is rounded with a sleep.